I remember just an overwhelming feeling of like, why are these animals feared? Like, why are people so afraid of them? Why don't people like them? Because I was face to face with an alligator and all I felt was peace in that moment. I knew crocodilians was what I wanted to do. They're just incredibly misunderstood creatures. They're not these aggressive monsters that we make them out to be. My name is Hallie Cowan. I'm one of the coordinators here at Fauna Forever. Basically do a little bit of everything, but I specialize in crocodilians. Fauna Forever does long-term monitoring of a bunch of things, but one of those things is caimans. We have three species of caiman here in the Tambopata River: the smooth-fronted caiman, black caiman, and white caiman, also known as spectacled caiman. When we're on a caiman survey, 9 out of 10 caimans are probably going to be white caimans. We get dwarf caimans more in the smaller streams, but we will also get them in our main river. They're the smallest crocodilian we have here, and they're really special because they are more forest-dwelling. They're one of the most terrestrial crocodilians in the world, and they have very pronounced osteoderms, which are the bony ridges on their back, and they're just incredible looking, like dragons. Black caimans are the biggest caiman we have here. They are one of the largest crocodilians. They get about the same size as American alligators, and they're darker and very smooth. We survey the populations to see like population demographics, so like male, females, making sure we have hatchlings, what year are the hatchlings from. We also do project-based things. So right now we're working on a growth rates project where we are taking a lot of our long-term data from pit tagging and using these unique codes in the pit tag to see recaptures and how much caimans have grown during a certain amount of time, and comparing different size classes. And we also are looking at some ecology of like, do caimans prefer certain microhabitats to others, which we know they do, but it's trying to figure out what variables matter the most. Our normal caiman nights will start once the sun goes down. It needs to be night so that we can see their eye shine. Once we locate a caiman, we will take the boat as close as we can towards it. And either Chris and I will be ready to catch. Once we collect a caiman, we bring it back in the boat and we collect morphometric data. So things like total body length, snout vent length, head width, head length, and then we'll take tail circumference. We also pit tag all our caimans, even the juveniles, so that if we ever recapture them, we know exactly what caiman it is because it has a unique number that we scan, and we can go back in our data and see all the measurements we took of it. Chris Ketola is leading a study that looks at mercury content in the caimans. So there's a lot of mining in this section of the river, but we also have the reserve in another section of the river. So if we can survey and take samples from the caimans over here with a lot of mining and take samples from areas with zero mining, really, then we can compare the mercury content in the caimans and look at caimans as bioindicators. If an intern asked me what they should do to prepare to come here, I would say just keep an open mind and be ready to advocate for yourself. A lot of interns don't want to ask us questions because they feel like they're bothering us, but it's literally the opposite. We love questions, we love what we do, we want to talk about it. So right away when interns come, they can help scribe, so they can help write down the data. This sounds boring, but to me, I really like it because it's a good way to help you learn the species, the ecology of the species, how they act. Usually, very quickly, someone can at least hold a caiman or help with the measurements themselves and like holding the measuring tape and like weighing and stuff like that. So a lot of interns can get experience right off the bat with our caiman surveys. We do our surveys pretty much the way you would do most crocodilian surveys. Our captures are with the snare and pull or hand grab. So if you learn caiman methodology here, that's pretty applicable across the board for crocodilian methodologies. You learn how to use different morphometrics to tell different things. So for example, we take tail circumference, and that we use as an indicator of how healthy they are. The base of their tail has like a lot of their big muscles that they use to swim a lot, so muscles that they depend on. So it's a really good way to know if a caiman is getting too skinny or if a caiman's like pretty healthy and bulky, right? One reason I also really love caimans and doing caimans with interns is a lot of interns would be scared and would never hold a caiman. And I think it's really cool to see interns hold their first caiman, look at it, and see all the intricate details that you don't usually get to see up close. And I think that grows an affinity for them. It like makes them more understood. I think working with caimans in particular, it's just always a surprise. Like the other night we had all three species caught in the same night. And that's never happened before. So I think that they just never cease to surprise you. They're always so interesting to look at, to feel in your hands, those osteoderms, just to like see them and feel them, and just learning about them, getting a recapture is just like such a high. And I think it's just a combination of all those things that just make it so exciting every night we do it.